One of the big buzzwords a couple of weeks ago on Twitch was the DMCA takedowns and strikes that could be affecting your channel via clips that people have created or even you have created for your channel. And while the buzz has kind of died down, it's still a strong, valid concern. It's such a valid concern that actually Twitch even tweeted out the fact that they've made updates to the way that clips are created and scrubbed to where if it finds some copyrighted material, they're just gonna auto-delete it to protect them and you. And this is why I wanna make a video on how you can save all of the content memories that you've generated on Twitch's platform. But also I wanna show you how to wipe the slate clean if you don't care about your clips, so that way you'll be safe going forward, okay? Hey all, Wild for Games here, making sure you have a bigger and better Twitch streaming career, but let's jump right into it. If you just wanna wipe the slate clean because you don't care about your clips because they're just probably just random moments that somebody just, you know, clipped, or they're embarrassing moments, or they're just not even entertaining, probably best just to delete it all. And luckily for you, Twitch actually just released, as I'm making this video, an update to their clip manager. If you go to the top right corner and click under your creative dashboard, go over to content and click under clips, you will now see in the top left corner a box that you can click on right next to info that allows you to highlight all of your clips and delete the selected or delete all clips that have been created. If you want to wipe the slate clean, this is probably the best way to protect yourself if you're worried about DMCA strikes and takedowns. Now let's say you're a streamer who's been on the platform for a number of years and you don't want to get rid of all those memories because they mean something to you and you want to reflect back on them, or perhaps you want to use them for future content on social media or fill in the blank. Well, Twitch doesn't really have a way to batch capture all of these clips, which really sucks. I'm sure they're working on it, but it's gonna take a little bit of time. But we want something now. And luckily there is a nice little third-party program that you can use that's called twitchanz.com. When you get to this platform here, go over to the right-hand side where you will see clip search tool. In the top left corner, it's kind of hard to see, you will see a login button that grants access to the program to read your VODs and clips. You need to click authorize for this to work. Once you've given it authorization, you'll see a from and a to. And this is where you want to pick when you have first started streaming on Twitch. Now there's two easy ways to figure this out if you don't remember. Maybe you're old like me and you forget things. I don't remember when I started streaming. Two easiest ways, if you go to twitchmetrics.net, type in your username, over on the right hand side, it'll show you when you created your account. Won't be the start streaming date, but hey, it gives you a leap off point. If you haven't streamed for more than 10 concurrent viewers, this will not pull your information. The next easiest way is if you go to your Twitch channel, in your own chat, just type in a basic sentence there. And when it populates your name, click on it and it should show you the date you created your account. Those are two easy ways. Put the date that you started and put today's date of whenever you're gonna be downloading stuff, and go over to the right-hand side where it says username and click search. This will populate every single clip that's ever been made about your channel. If you want to download all these clips, over on the right hand side, you will see batch download. When you click this, this is going to download to your actual download folder on your PC. What I recommend before you click download is make sure you clear out the directory for that day. So when it downloads everything, it'll download it underneath that particular day, which will be easy to select all and move it to whichever hard drive or thumb drive you want to keep all of these clips on. Now this program is really dope because it doesn't seem like anything is compressed or there's any information lost making the clips look bad. There is still a few problems with it. The biggest one being it doesn't label what the clips are. They're just labeled as whatever the unique identifier of when the clip was first generated, or a mishmash of the data in there. So there's no titles, which kind of really stinks. So at some point you'll probably have to go through your clips and decide if you want to keep them or just delete them. Now I consider this program just a placeholder until Twitch develops something better for us all to use. I don't know when that will be, hopefully soon. But if you feel concerned about your clips or copyright strikes or DMCA or anything like that, this is a good alternative at the moment. And if you're a bigger streamer out there, I would probably recommend you do something proactive rather than have anything retroactively hurt your channel. I'm glad I could show you guys an awesome program so that way it saves all these memories that you've crafted on this platform. I don't want them going away. I want you to use them and reflect back on them and perhaps even laugh on a couple of them. Now, if you're still concerned with copyright strikes, DMCA, what music you can have on your stream. Hey, those are all valid concerns. I'm gonna put a video over here to the side that I did about safe music that you can't stream. I really recommend checking that video out because it's gonna help you as you continue your broadcast on stream. That does it for me. I'm tired. I wanna get done. I'll see you guys all later. Take care, and of course, peace.